Japan's prime minister has announced a plan to loosen legal limits on its military. Abe wants Japan's armed forces to be able to support its allies and UN peacekeepers in the event of conflict. He calls it collective self-defense. Since the end of World War II, a strict interpretation of the pacifist constitution prevented any Japanese military activity outside its territory. Japanese public opinions divided on Abe's plans. Japan's neighbors are alarmed. South Korea's foreign ministry reacted angrily, and in Beijing, China's spokesperson said the world must remain alert to Japanese militarism.
Abe has taken a series of unprecedented moves since he assumed office. In view of the recent negative trends happening in Japan concerning historical issues, Asian countries and the international community, including China, have every reason to be on high alert for Japan's real intention and future tendency.
Anti-government protesters in Thailand forced the acting prime minister to flee a meeting to talk about upcoming general elections. The protesters want the caretaker government to resign, and about 100 of them invaded a meeting between the politicians and the country's election commission. The officials had to scramble to escape. Meantime, a grenade and machine gun attack on the protesters' main encampment in Bangkok killed at least 3 people and injured more than 20. Both incidents cast doubt on whether Thailand will hold its July 20th election to replace Yingluck Shinawat. In South Korea, the captain and 2 crew members of the stricken ferry have been indicted for murder. They abandoned the capsized ferry before most passengers got off. They also didn't make evacuation announcements for the use of Sewol's rescue facilities, like rafts and life jackets. 264 people, many of them high school students, died in the disaster. 20 are still missing a month after the ferry sank.
Hi, I'm Thuy Vu, the host of Link Asia. Catch Link Asia every Friday on Link TV, 9:30 p.m. Eastern, 6:30 p.m. Pacific. Check our website for local listings on KCET Los Angeles and PBS's The World Channel.